CJ, was that kind of the complete performance you guys were looking for?
Yeah, I mean, as long as we got better as a team, I think everyone's going to be happy. You know, yesterday we didn't play too well, but I mean, coming in today, we came in with energy and played the right way for most of the game, and that's always a good thing.
Did it need to be said, like, did coach have to tell you, hey, you got to have better energy, or did you guys just know yourselves that we need to play better?
We knew last night at halftime, we came out, we just know we had energy, so we knew we had to come in today with a lot of energy, and that's what we did.
Abdul, three games in, what's good and what's still a work in progress?
Good is we're getting better each game. Players are starting to step up. We got our guys knocking down shots. We're moving on offense and stuff like that. Playing good defense for long stretches. We just got to make it complete for 40 minutes. And we really got to improve this rebounding thing. You know, that's something coaches are getting on us about. Teams are getting a lot of offensive rebounds against us, so we got to shore that up.
Is it just a matter of boxing out?
Being more scrappy, you know, getting the loose rebounds. You know, guards got to come back and get rebounds, box out, same thing. So it's just something we got to work at, you know, watch on film, see where we're missing them, and then correct it.
What difficult is it for the like guards to do that? Because you guys have somebody that has to be back, right, to be that safety?
I mean, it's more – that's on offense. We're talking about defense, you know. It's more – sometimes it's a rotation, you know, Aziz goes for a block, so you can't be, somebody has to rotate and box his guy out when he goes for a block. And we just got to, you know, look at the film, see which guy has to rotate down and then correct it, you know, because that can cost us.
Abdul, on your alley-oop to Tony, did it look open all the way? I mean, the guy defended pretty well.
It looked open, like the guy was coming up and then Tone went, and then he kind of like see me fake and then go back, and so he backed up and I just threw it. I just knew if I threw a high enough tone, go get it.
Did either of you guys make a conscious effort to try to get Terrence off a little bit tonight?
Terrence can get himself off, really.
Wow.
But in a sense that, like, he can score so good that if he's hot, you go to him, you know, and I was looking for him. Other guys were looking for him, and, you know, him and CJ balance each other out. You know, teams got to guard both of them. And if one's hot, the other one, you know, they're focused on the other one. And so it's just a balance.
Hey, how is the dynamic when you two guys are out there?
Me and him?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's great because then I can play the two. And then Tone can make plays. He's a great passer. So, you know, I become more of a shooter. And then Tone can make plays. And he also could pick up the ball more, so I'm guarding off the ball, just things like that. And we can switch that off. You know, I can pick up the ball, and then he play off the ball. So we're interchangeable that way.
Did you guys have other opportunities for that alley-oop, and it just wasn't there? And that one third game, at that moment, it was just sort of...
It's just kind of a chemistry thing. You know, I just got to know when to throw it to him. And, you know, he kind of has... Him, Terrence, and CJ, they all are great athletes, so I can pretty much throw it up by the rim, and they'll go get it, so... It's just a chemistry thing, just knowing when to throw it to him and then making the right play.
Tony, could you describe what the conversation was when Coach Romarmi called the timeout and kind of pulled you aside a little bit?
I was just, you know, about having more pride than my man scored more than once. You know, he knows I'm one of the best defenders on the team, and for somebody to score more than once to me is just disappointing. You know, he just brought me to the side, so, you know, take pride and D him up.
Tony, we've seen you guard guys that are significantly shorter than you, these little quick guys. What kind of challenges does that present, and do you feel pretty comfortable doing it?
I mean, it's not easy because they're real small. They're right to the ground, so they're quicker. They're quick, but, you know, me being long, me being able to spread my arms out, and just I don't got to be as close up to them, it's able for me to play good defense. So it's tough, but at the end of the day, I'm able to keep my composure and be able to D up.
How different is the defensive system, Tony, here?
Oh, it's like 360, you know, because in high school, I didn't know what defense was, you know, so I was just okay. Trying to guard my person, you don't score. But in college, you got, you know, help side, and you got to know where the ball is, you got lob, you got all the little things, you know, that matters and helps you just a lot better defense. So it was a total 360.
How far do you think you are along in that regard?
I came a long way. Because when I first got here, I was when the ball away from me, I'm just hugging my man, not worried about being in help. So now that we're a few games in, I'm a lot better than I was.
Tony, what
Tony. Somebody had to ask. Your free throws.
Oh my God, it's terrible right now. I don't understand. Like,
what's going on?
Man, yeah, I don't know, but you know, just nothing I can't work on. You know,
you get advice from some of the other guys, I'm sure.
I mean, I'm just saying, you know, follow through, whatever, but, you know, it's just mental right now. You know, I'm definitely going to be in the gym constantly working on it. You know, it's nothing I can't make improvement on.
I got to bring coaching, guys, okay?